in 2005, I read in the New York Times about a young man from the Dominican Republic who had just won an award at Princeton to go study at Oxford. And he was one of the best classicists that Princeton had seen in about 10 years. He couldn't go to Oxford, however, because he was undocumented. And he came out and said that he was undocumented and asked for everybody's help. Well, the U.S. government did not want to give him a citizenship. I mean, why would you want to do that to the smartest person around? Nor did anybody else seem to care. And he finally did get to Oxford and got to come back on an F-1 visa. You might ask why I'm talking about him and not about myself, but I think that this story struck me because it reflects a lot of my interests. First, I come from an immigrant background myself, and even though I didn't face the same problems, a lot of the fears were still there, and a lot of the challenges were as well. And that got me interested in the education of others, of the marginalized, not only of undocumented students, but of Native Americans, of the poor, of students from countries that have been adversely affected in some way, often by something that the United States has done. And it was part of my mission at the time because I was quietly doing what Princeton was doing, that is, funneling some international funds, I mean, with the permission of the office, of course, to students who might not otherwise be able to get an education. We could not come out and talk about it at the time because there were dangers in doing that for the student as well. So we went through the DREAM Act, and now we are building walls around ourselves and we're threatened to get rid of that. This student, who did end up coming back and is now a professor of classics at Princeton, represented for me the plight of the person who is marginalized, the hope that somebody has when his ideas are nurtured, but I wondered why it had to depend on luck. He had a great counselor, and it is part of our mission to prepare counselors who can help kids like this get a superb education. It was also about the liberal arts. It was about somebody who wanted to be a humanist when others from his position cannot be because they're worried about getting food on the table. It was about ideas and the nurturing of ideas, but most of all, it was about creating a cultural capital through understanding others that we need as a part of education now more than ever when walls are being built around us, both figuratively and physically. So I hope I got to do some of this with my work as Vice President for Government Relations with IACAC. And I got to talk about cases like this on the Hill, and I hope to bring all of these to the national level as well, because they're especially important ideas in very troubled times. Thank you very much.